Hi Manindal, welcome back to Digital Design Lab. Okay, in this video, you will see an important application or one of the application of a circuit called decoder, right? Specifically, the aim of this experiment is we have to design a circuit called full adder. I hope you already aware of full adder from the previous class videos. Okay, we need to design the same full adder. Okay, which will perform addition operation using 3-to-8 decoder IC and 4 input bit NAND gate, right? I will come back to this 4 input bit NAND gate in few minutes. Before that, we shall see about 3-to-8 decoder at a high level. Anyhow, you will learn about this 3-to-8 decoder in depth in theory classes. So, for the time being, understand a decoder is basically an electronic circuit which will take n number of inputs, and it will have 2 to the power of n output lines. So at a time, you will get for a specific input, you will get 1 out of 2 to the power of n combinations output. Clear? Okay, but anyhow, as I said, you will learn that in theory classes. Okay, and one more piece of information that you have to understand with respect to decoder is we can have a decoder with enabled input or without enabled input, right? So an enabled input is an additional input to this decoder IC. So as the name itself says, if we supply a signal to this enable pin, then you will get an output here. If you don't provide a proper or if you don't provide an input for an enable pin, then you can't able to get output in the output pins. That's what the use of enable pins. So as I said, you may have a decoder circuit with enable pin or without enable pin. Clear? Without enable pin means you will not find this particular. So we will not find any additional input like enable, as I said previously. Clear? Okay. A better example for a decoder is, as I said, usually it will comes with like this n 2 to the power of n, right? So in the market, you can have a decoder like this. So which will take 2 inputs, or which will have 2 input line and 4 output line. We call this decoder as an 2 to 4 decoder. So 2 input line will be there in case of 2 to 4 decoder, and 4 output line will be there in case of 2 to 4 decoder. And as I said, you can have this decoder with enabled pin or without enabled pin. Okay, with enabled pin means you will have an enabled pin like this. This is without enabled pin. If you need enabled decoder, then you will have additional input like enable, like this, something like this. So this is one example for a decoder. So you can have a decoder like with a specification like this also, 3-to-8 decoder. So as the name itself says, this is a decoder which will take 3 inputs or 3 input line, and it will have 8 output lines will be there in this case. Again, you can have a decoder, 3-to-8 decoder with enabled pin or without enabled pin. Clear? Okay. And like this, you can have 4 to what? How many output lines will be there in case of 2 to the power of n decoder? 2 to the power of 4 is 16. 4 to 16 decoder. In this case, 4 input lines will be there and 16 output line will be there. So this is how a decoder will be available for us in the market. So I hope you got some information about decoder, right? So this is the pin diagram. So now we shall have a look at the pin diagram. Of the IC which we'll use in this experiment is 7438, which represent a decoder, specifically 3-to-8 decoder. So this is the IC. For a 3-to-8 decoder, the IC number is 74138. So which are the input lines here? Can you see A, B, C? These are 3 input lines. Okay, and which are the output lines here? Can you see Y0, Y1, Y2, Y3, Y4, Y5, Y6, and y7. Totally from 0 to 7 is totally 8. So these, all these are, along with this pin, all these are output pins. Output pins or output lines, right? And what are this? G2A, G2B and G1. What are those? All these three pins represent enable pins. Okay. So what is this bar represent? Means this pin, the pin number 4, will take a complemented input. Complemented input means there will be a bubble like this. Okay. And the input line can be imagined like this. If you supply 1 as an input through this line, so actually it will supply 0 to this IC, clear? Because of this bubble. That's what we will, that's why we call this as an complemented input line. Again, this pin number 5 is also a complemented input line, whereas pin number 6 is uncomplemented. Uncomplemented means if you supply 1 as a signal to this line, it will supply 1 only. If you supply 0 as a signal through this line, it will supply 0 only, like this. So this is how it will work. And pin number 8 as usually a ground pin, and pin number 16 as usually it's an voltage pin. Means we need to supply voltage to pin number 16 and we need to supply ground signal to pin number 8. Totally, so you have a look at this IC, totally it is of 16 pin IC. And already we have learned that usually there will be a curve at one end of the IC. We call this end as the top end of the IC. Top end of the IC, opposite one is called as an bottom of the IC. So this is what you should know before designing a logic diagram for full adder using 3 to 8 decoder. So this is one important piece of information that you should know. Along with this, we will use another interesting IC called 4 input bit NAND gate. So remember, so what is actually our aim was, we need to design a full adder circuit, right? Sorry, we need to design a full adder circuit, correct? Using 3 to 8 decoder and 4 input bit NAND gate, right? This is was our aim, right? NAND gate. So this is the pin diagram. So actually for a 4 input bit NAND gate, this is the pin diagram whose IC number of 4 input bit NAND gate is 7420. Remember, you need to remember the IC numbers and as well as pin diagram. So have a look at this pin diagram, okay, which is actually a pin diagram of 4 input bit NAND gate. So how many pin chip it is? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So totally it is a 14 pin chip. And pin number 7, as usually we need to supply ground to pin number 7 and we need to supply voltage to pin number 14. And one 7420 IC will give us two 4 input bit NAND gate. See, can you see this is one NAND gate? How many number of inputs it is taking? 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So totally it is 4 input bit NAND gate, right? So this is one 4 input bit NAND gate, and this is another 4 input bit NAND gate. We call this as a second 4 input bit NAND gate. So 17420 IC will have two 4 input bit NAND gate, right? Clear? So if our aim is to use this first 4 input bit NAND gate, then we need to supply input to which pin numbers? We need to supply input to pin number 1, pin number 2, pin number 4 and 5. And where we will get the output? At pin number 6. So what about this pin number 3? We will not use this pin number 3. Can you see here? We will not use this pin number 3. You can treat this as not connected or not used. Okay, pin number 3 of 7420 will not be used. Okay, similarly, if your aim is to use a second 4 input bit NAND gate, then you need to supply input to pin number 13, pin number 12, then pin number 10, pin number 9, and where you will get output? At pin number 8. And what about this pin number 11? We will not use, we are not using or not connected. Okay, so these informations should be there in your mind before designing a circuit for full adder. Clear? So now we have we got an idea of pin number of 7420, and along also we have an idea of pin diagram of 3-to-8 decoder, right? And now we shall start the design. We shall start a design with the truth table as usual. Okay, this is the truth table of full adder. So A, B, C represent inputs, three inputs of the full adder, and sum and carry represent two output pins of the full adder circuit. And in the previous video itself, I already explained you how to come up with the values for sum and values for carry for different combinations of ABC values, right? Clear? Okay. So with the hope that you already have gone through the previous video, I will continue with the next steps that is required to design a full adder using 3-to-8 decoder and 4 input bit NAND gate. So for better understanding, what I will do now is I will represent this row, I mean rows, with a decimal number. So actually 000, the decimal equivalent of the binary 000 is 0, right? And 001 is 1, 010 is 2. What actually I'm writing here? Decimal equivalent of the binary values. And 011 is a binary value. If you convert 011 to a decimal, then it will become decimal value 3. Similarly, 4, 5, then this is 6, and this is 7. Clear? Okay, so we need this. I will tell you in few seconds why do we need this decimal equivalent. Okay, now let us come as usual. The next step after getting the truth table, the next step in the design procedure is we need to come up with a Boolean expression, right? Boolean expression for outputs. Okay, outputs in this case means sum and carry. We shall go one by one. First, we shall focus on sum. So either you can represent Boolean expression in min term, as I said in the previous video only, or max term. Okay, we shall go ahead with the min term representation. Clear? Okay. Okay. To come up with the min term expression for sum, what we have to do? First, we need to focus on only on sum column, right? Only on sum column. Then we need to pick the rows which has 1 as the output, correct? Or has 1 as a value for sum, right? Correct? Okay, we need a decimal representation 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. As you all know that min term can also be represented by another representation called sigma m representation. I hope you have learned this in theory class, a sigma m representation. What actually we will represent here? So here we'll represent the row numbers. Okay, so where you are getting 1, in which row number you are getting 1 as a value for sum? Row number 1, right? Row number 1, right? So what would be the first min term for sum? M1. Then this one, I mean second row number 2, M2. Similarly, which one? Then M4. Then which one? M7. So these are min terms for sum. So it can also be written like this: sigma m of 1, 2, 4, 7 is the min term for sum. Similarly, in the same way, you can come up with an min term representation for or sigma m representation for carry. What would be the carry value? So directly to save the time, directly I'm going here. So row number is 3, then 5, because at row number 5 you have one value for carry, 5, then 6, 7, okay, 6, 7, correct? Exactly the same thing has been written in the manual. Can you see here? 1, 2, 4, 7 is the min term value for sum, and 3, 5, 6, 7, which we got recently, is the min term or sigma m representation for carry. Clear? Okay, after getting this sigma m notation, finally, it is very easy to come up with a final logic diagram for full adder. Okay, so how we can able to do this is very simple. First, draw the pin diagram, or first place 3-to-8 decoder. This is IC number 74138 is nothing but 3-to-8 decoder. First place 3 to 8 decoder on the left side, right? Then remember A, B, C are nothing but the inputs for the full adder. These three are nothing but the inputs. So A is actually MSB and C is the least significant bit. I hope you people are familiar with the MSB and LSB concept. Okay, if I say 0, 0, 0 is the input, which is the MSB and which is the least significant bit here? So usually the least significant bit will be this. Okay, LSB, this is the least significant bit, this is the most significant bit. So you, based on that concept, you can supply the inputs like this. A over here, pin number 2, 3, B to pin number 2, C to pin number 1, like this. A, B, C are nothing but inputs. And what actually these three are? Interesting, what actually these three are? Okay, just have a look at the pin diagram of 74138, I mean decoder. Actually, these are enable pins. What we have to do? Or what we have to supply this to this enable pins, the proper signals, right? Then only you can expect output over here. Okay, that's why, as I said in few minutes back, these enable pins E1, E2, actually they are complemented enable pins. So what we have to supply, actually we need to supply, see, can you see here, these two pins, pin number 4 and 5 has been made common, and for these two they are supplying ground, or they are connected to ground. I mean ground is nothing but zero, means they are actually supplying zero as a signal to pin number 4 and to pin number 5. Since they are supplying zero for pin number 4 and 5, and since they are complemented input, actually you are supplying one to the IC. So as a result it will work, means you are making the IC to work, correct? And interesting thing is there is one more enable pin called E3, which actually uncomplemented, hence you have connected that to voltage. Means remember, you are supplying signal 1 to that pin. So hence, since you are supplying 1 as a signal, and since it is uncomplemented, 1 will be supplied to the IC, means you are actually enabling, or you are making that IC to work. Clear? So this is how you need to treat. And from the pin diagram we already know that pin number 8 should be supplied with zero signal, or should be connected to ground, and pin number 16 should be connected to VCC. Is it clear? Okay, see, after this you arrange the output line in such a way that okay, like this 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 like this. I will tell you in few seconds or minutes why it is not in order. But first you try to list the output lines in such a way that it will be in order, like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, like this. Totally how many output lines will be there? Totally 8 output lines will be there. Okay, then after that I will tell you why they have rearranged. Okay, after that rearrange these output lines. So remember, whenever you rearrange this output line, the corresponding pin number will also has to be rearranged. So for if I want to give a simple example, so you have a look at this. What actually this is Y6. This is nothing but Y6. Don't get confused with O bar. O bar has been used here, and previously when we look at the pin diagram, actually it was Y6. Okay, see, label can be given in it. It can be given as Y or O or P, it does not matter. Why they have used bar here means because, can you have a look at these output lines? All have a bubble, right? See, this bubble represent that they will produce complemented output. That's why they have represent that they have used bar for every output line. Clear? So that is the reason why they have used bar here. So this is the what point I want to explain was, okay, this is pin number output line 6, right? Whose pin number is 9, right? So if you have a look at the pin diagram of 74138, can you have a look at this? Y6 output line pin number is 9. So again, this is what I said, even though if you rearrange the output lines, I will tell you in few minutes why they have rearranged the pin number. Okay, pin number will be same, has to be same. Clear? Okay, now after doing this, the next step is very easy. Okay, so for sum, what was the min term? What was the min term for sum? What was the min term? Min term was 1, 2, 4, 7, right? It means you need to connect. Okay, it means you need to connect. Okay, Y1 or O1 bar. Okay, Y1 or O1 bar. See here, 1, 2, 4, and 7. I mean, make it simple. Output line 1, output line 2, output line 4, output line 7 should be connected as an input to 4 input bit NAND gate whose IC number is 7420. Clear? Okay. Then if you supply those as an input to NAND gate, 4 input bit NAND gate, you will can expect some at pin number. What is the pin number? What is the pin output pin number for the first 4 input bit NAND gate as per the IC number of or pin diagram of 7420? 7420. Have a look at this. Have a look at the pin diagram of 7420. If you supply inputs at pin number 1, 2, 4, and 5, where you will get the output? At pin number 6, right? At pin number 6, right? Okay. So where you will get the output? At pin number 6. So this is pin number 6. Similarly, if you look at the carry min term expression for carry, see it is 3, 5, 6, 7, correct? It means you need to connect output line 3, 5, 6, at 7. Can you see here? That's why they have taken a common connection here. This is line 7, output line 7, as an input to the one more 4 input bit NAND gate to get a carry expression. Clear? To get a carry expression. What put bit the output line here, line number here? What again to write output line, what you need? Pin diagram. So what would be the output line? 8, right? 8, right? So what would be the pin number for this output line? It is 8. At pin number 8 of 7420, you will get a carry term. Clear? And at pin number 6, right? 6, I think. 6, you will get some term. Okay, at which pin number? Pin number 6 of 7420 IC, you will get some. So this is a full ladder. Actually, this is a full ladder which will take 3 inputs like A, B, and C and produces 2 output. One is sum and carry. And we have designed this full ladder. Okay, we have designed this full ladder using 3 to 8 decoder and 4 input bit NAND gates. So that was our aim. And now finally, we have designed this full ladder circuit using 3 to 8 decoder and 4 input bit NAND gate. Clear? I hope you understood the design procedure. I have made this design procedure very simple without going internal details of how actually it will convert or simplification. I have not shown anyhow, which you will learn in theory classes. But here I have explained which is required for carrying out an experiment in the laboratory. Clear? So this Y naught line or O naught bar line is not used, it will be left open. Why means it is very simple. So if you look at the minterm expression for sum and as well as carry, you will not find a minterm with zero. See, can you whether there is a term called zero over here? No. Whether zero over here? No. Hence this pin. Okay, hence the output line Y naught or O naught bar will not be used. Clear? So this is how usually we can able to design a full ladder using 3 to 8 decoder and 4 input bit NAND gate. Clear? And after doing connection according to this logic diagram, what you have to do actually is you need to verify the truth table of the full ladder. I mean, you need to verify this truth table. So that's what you have to do in this experiment. So in the coming class videos, I will explain you how to use this logic diagram, how to use this logic diagram and can able to do the connection and how we can able to verify the respective truth table that we shall see in the coming class videos. So finally, I will conclude this. So what actually we learned is we learned one more interesting experiment called application of decoder, and we have designed a full ladder to show one of the usage of a decoder circuit. And actually we did is we designed a full ladder circuit using 3-to-8 decoder specifically and 4 input bit NAND gate. Clear? Okay. If you have any doubt with respect to this, you can either call me or you can message me. So I will get in touch with you and I will clarify your doubt. So thank you one and all.